issue. It's safe to say that maybe there might be some weakening with it. We're going to also chime in with Dr. Alison Nugent in just a bit. But yeah, it looks, you know, it could go right in the middle of the channel and not make landfall over either island. It's kind of a wait and see situation.
Yeah, very interesting to see. So we'll have to see how this plays out. Not very common that a well-formed tropical storm or hurricane interacts with 10 or 13,000 foot mountains. So
yeah, exactly.
We'll check back in with you guys in just a bit. For now,
right.
I'm meteorologist David Yeomans. We'll send it back to you guys.
Thanks, Dave. All right, that's a good question. Let's do a follow-up with you, if we can. Dr. Nugent, if you could step back. The reason why I didn't have you earlier with me is because she doesn't have an earpiece like I do, so she would not be able to hear the question. So he had a very good question about the path and the interaction between two very tall mountains, one 10,000 feet, of course, the other 13,000 feet. Would you think there's kind of any interaction as far as the track? And then we'll ask you about as far as the potential intensity. Could it be, could this thing be like squeezed into that channel maybe?
Yeah, absolutely. So there's some studies that I've read on Taiwan, mm-hmm. as well as a study that I did on Dominica, an island in the Caribbean, where when you have a rotating storm coming near island terrain, mm-hmm. you get local high and pressure, high and low pressures, depending on where the wind is. So if the wind mm-hmm. is hitting Maui and hitting this side of the Big Island, then you can get a high pressure here and a low pressure here, and you can have the storm center kind of jog to where the low pressure is.
Mm-hmm.
So it's certainly a possibility that the islands being there, the island interaction with the storm can affect where the storm goes. But mm-hmm. the other thing that I wanted to point out is that as the tropical storm weakens, sometimes it's really hard to know where the center of the storm is.
Right, right.
Sometimes it's really hard to identify the exact location mm. of the center. So
sometimes it is a guesstimate because you don't even have an eye that you can look at. If I may suggest an analogy for people at home to kind of think about this, is that this is a river of water, okay? This cone is a river of water. This path is a river of water. And you have a huge rock on one side and a huge rock on the other. And as the river of water approaches both rocks, the water gets squeezed in and sometimes a bit accelerated. Is that you know, you got to think of air as a fluid. Whether we think of air as a fluid, not so much you know, as air itself, but that kind of effect.
Yeah, you can also have it's the same thing that we see with trade winds accelerating mm-hmm. in between the gaps and islands. We could see local accelerations in the winds due to the island influence as well.
Okay. And sometimes, you know, the forecast models don't pick up on it because it's a very, you know, microclimate kind of thing.
Yeah, that's actually a really great point, is that most of the models have really large grid spaces.
Mm.
So imagine you take Oahu and you average its terrain in one box.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe that's a bit extreme, but it's not capturing all of the contours and the details in the terrain.
Mm-hmm.
And so in a model, you're not getting that.
Additionally, we haven't had a system come from this far north, this high latitude. I mean, Isel came pretty much from the east, okay, kind of came. Then we had Iniki coming all the way from the south. Lane last week came from the south. And we've had systems coming in and then coming in from the south. Folks, this is historic. Like, this is the first time we've actually had a system come in from this high latitude and this angle from basically a trade wind direction. Pretty historic.
Yeah, it's definitely an interesting track.
And by the way, you know, keep in mind, it's 9/11, Hurricane Iniki, you know, 1992. It's not going to, if this does hit portions of the Big Island of Maui, it's not going to hit tonight, but it's pretty darn close, the next day. So some very interesting developments. Let's look at the satellite presentation. As the system is 125 miles east of Kahului, Maui, are you surprised? I mean, because I'm pretty fascinated about this new track change.
Mm. So I have a new theory on the track change.
Ooh, juicy, juicy.
So,
okay,
so
tell me.
You're visualizing it as as a shift. And yes, it is a change. The last one didn't have the Big Island in it so much, okay. But I see it more as a focusing. So as okay. the storm gets closer, it's also narrower. So it mm-hmm. makes sense that as the storm gets closer, there are islands that were in the cone of uncertainty before and now mm-hmm. aren't. And it's more of like a focusing of that track as it gets closer.
That's a very good point, because we're not dealing with a wider area farther out in time. We're dealing with a closer area in a very small amount of time. In fact, these are, you know, these are like 12-hour intervals, right?
Yeah, and so, but yeah. we do definitely see more of the Big Island in the cone of uncertainty this time
okay.
than last time. But last time, I think it was more like this. Yeah. It was wider, yeah. and it was a little bit further north. But I see it more as a focusing.
Okay, so she's absolutely correct. It's a contraction of the cone, but it's with it a slight
yes.
shift to the south. So
yeah. And we've also seen the speed being really variable today. Mm-hmm. It's increased, then it's decreased, and you know, we've even seen in the visible imagery the low-level center accelerating mm-hmm. westward. And I have an analogy for this one.
Okay.
Say you're in a speeding car and you're going really fast.
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty easy to predict where you're going to be in 30 seconds
mm-hmm.
because you're moving so quickly. But now imagine you're in a you know, you're riding a bike
mm-hmm.
and you're starting to slow down. You may not know where you're going to be in 30 seconds because you might go so slow you fall over, you might be wobbly.
Mm-hmm.
And so I see that as the storm is slowing down,
mm-hmm.
it's kind of becoming more erratic. It's speeding up, slowing down. Also, as it weakens, then the steering influence is different.
Mm-hmm.
So when it's deeper, those upper level winds are more important. But as it weakens and it gets less deep, then the lower level winds are more important.
So what you're saying, this is harder to forecast.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, I'll take that as a weaker system.
We could just say,
yeah.
Hashtag, it's complicated.
Okay, yeah, pretty much. And you're right, you know, with a weaker system, there's less, you know, to work with, you know. We can't even really pinpoint a center sometimes.
Yeah.
Okay, so a couple different scenarios here. So scenario number one, the center of the system stays directly in the Alinui Haha channel and does not make landfall. So that means that the last tropical system officially verified by satellites and data would be Isel and Darby, and Isel came in with about 40 mile per hour winds. If this were to make landfall over the Big Island, the winds, well, at this point it's 45, so we are looking at a slightly stronger system should the intensity forecast holds, okay? And so this would be the Big Island on record would still not have a hurricane hit, thankfully. The only island to have one is Kauai. Maui would not have been hit by any cyclone officially since the satellite era. So there's a few historical things that could be going on here. But, you know, who knows what's going to happen? It could very well stay offshore as much as it grazes Maui and the Big Island. It's just one of these things that's unfortunately a wait and see. All right,
yeah.
let's do you want to add anything
yeah,
to this?
I actually
oh, yeah.
do.
Oh,
so
go
so
for
you
it,
said
go
something
for
about that won't be happening tonight, and I think you meant that won't be happening tonight before midnight, because it will be happening tonight.
Oh yeah. Yeah. On this day. September 11th.
On September 11th. Okay, fair enough. And I also think it's really important to note that depending on where the storm goes, the fastest winds will be on this side.
Mm-hmm.
This side will be a little bit weaker, and that's because the storm is spinning in this direction and it's moving in this direction. So those winds add together with the storm motion, and on this side they subtract. And so
45 plus 8.
Yes, exactly.
Around the center, at least.
45 plus 8, and then 45 minus 8
okay.
on the other side.
Mm-hmm.
And depending on how the forward motion changes, you may see changes in that.
Mm-hmm.
But also for the wind perspective, as the storm comes through, imagine it takes this center track. You'll see winds coming from this direction, and then as it moves forward, it'll move more southerly.
Mm-hmm.
And so as the storm moves, you'll see some pretty big changes in the wind direction as well.
Mm-hmm.
Depending, you know, if you're on the Big Island, you'll have winds from the south and then moving to the west, coming from the west. So just imagine that cyclone moving with you, and then mm-hmm. you can see kind of where your winds are.
Yeah, you got to kind of orient yourself, orient your island, yeah. you know, to the wind direction in a system that is spinning counterclockwise yeah. and moving and wobbling.
Yeah, so. It makes it a little tricky because I think most people in their local areas are used to the trade winds, so they're mm-hmm. used to these easterly winds, and they know what types of accelerations to expect for mm-hmm. that. But here we have something a little bit different, so just keep that in mind. There will be local wind funneling, local terrain effects mm-hmm. that'll affect your, in this case, we're just talking about wind. But yeah, some of those gusts look pretty high.
Yeah, they are. The spread between the gusts, I think, has widened. I'm not sure. Is this a formula or
no?
No. Okay.
I don't think so.
Yeah. Okay. I didn't know if it was an exact formula, but we've seen like only a 10 mile per hour difference sometimes in wind gusts and sustained winds, but this is. You know, we're talking a bigger margin here, so. 15.
Yeah, to be honest, I'm not sure. Yeah. I know when they do reconnaissance missions with mm-hmm. with the Hurricane Hunter aircraft, they mm-hmm. drop sons. Mm-hmm. They drop yeah. these basically weather sensors down into the storm, and they can measure winds in situ, in the place where it is.
Okay.
In this case, it may be some sort of a formula,
okay.
so I'm not sure.
Okay, fair enough. So at this point, when we see this go through tonight, the strongest winds still will be Maui County, right?
Yeah, strongest winds here, depending on the exact strength, maybe we should talk a little bit about tropical storm structure. So the strongest winds are near the center,
mm-hmm.
and as you go out from it, the pressure increases and the winds weaken. And so here where the circulation center is, that's where the strongest winds are.
Mm-hmm.
But as we saw talking to David, there's already some winds further out.
Yeah.
So he'll start seeing those winds pick up, and then all the deep convection, all these tall clouds with lots of rain and thunderstorms are on the down shear side. They're on the side that the upper level winds are blowing
towards. Shear's going
towards.
This way? Okay.
Yeah. And so what I think people will see is that there's wind impacts first, and then the rain impacts will lag.
All right.
And come on through a little bit later.
Yeah, later in the day, maybe on Wednesday. That looks like a really, really gnarly thunderstorm there. I'm going to go through a few slides to see if the future radar got updated. And it's still showing heavy rain offshore Maui at 1 a.m. tomorrow morning. And this is, you know, and kind of moving through the central portions of the state. And all in all, regardless of the track, right, we're going to see.
Yeah, regardless of the track, all the islands will be wet. Of course, depending on if those thunderstorms really localize over one of the islands,
mm-hmm.
then we could see some flash flooding and some really heavy rain scenarios.
That is what I'm kind of worried about the most, and is that if this thunderstorm
this is a healthy looking thunderstorm, this one that pops up to the southeast of the main area.
Mm-hmm.
We saw that thunderstorm be born.
I'm going to try to get a better angle right next to you. There we go. That's that thunderstorm cell that we're talking about that we have been watching over the last several hours, just saying, wow, this thing just popped up.
So the rotation center
nowhere.
You can see is here, moving this way.
Right here.
And then this one just grows and gets really big really fast.
And keep in mind, folks, just because we have it here doesn't mean we're going to have it here, because these thunderstorms do pop up and mm-hmm. dissipate and pop up and dissipate. What we're pretty sure that we're going to have is very similar environmental unstable conditions moving towards the islands. We're pretty sure we have the moisture, mm-hmm. and when you have unstable conditions and moisture, you have a problem. And now we have mountains.
Yeah, now you have mountains to provide the lifting so that you can realize that instability.
All right.
And one other thing is that, so while winds from a storm are pretty easy to predict, and when things are really symmetric, it's when a storm is symmetric, you can predict the impacts. But when you have something like this, convection is a little bit more sporadic. So mm-hmm. it's hard to say exactly where, you know, we don't know that there will be a thunderstorm here or here tomorrow. Mm-hmm. What we know is that the potential is there mm-hmm. for deep convection, for heavy rain. All the ingredients are there.
Okay. So I think the takeaway for Big Island and Maui residents right now is that we see it out there. We know that the thunderstorms are out there. We know that there's available moisture. We know that there's unstable conditions. We know it is headed to at least the heaviest rains potentially to be Maui as well as the Big Island. We know the mountains can extract it. And just giving fair warning, maybe it doesn't happen. Best case scenario that it doesn't happen, but the potential is there. So just giving folks a heads up, that's the only thing we could do. That's the really, yep. I mean, there's
yeah,
nothing.
We don't know where it's going to rain or when, but we know that all of the ingredients are there to make rain.
Yeah. And footnote, we hope it doesn't happen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I really hope it doesn't happen on the Big Island.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness.
I can't even think about that. They've already gotten way too much rain.
I think, you know, just talking with my friends that live in Hilo and live on the Big Island, I think, you know, even 24 hours ago when the track was, you know, shifted considerably
yeah,
to the north.
Yeah, I bet they were feeling much better.
And they're like, wow, you know, maybe we might catch a break. And then we see news like this and it's just like, oh, my goodness. Well, the eastern portions of the state, folks, under the gun for the heaviest rain, all islands could see heavy rain, and the flash flooding potential is there. Strongest winds will be still Maui County. I have to look at the graphs to see if the winds start picking up. You'd think that there's a possibility, and then the winds. I think a producer told me that the tropical storm warning was dropped for Kauai. Let me verify. It was? Thank you, Tina. Kauai and Niihau has been dropped from the tropical storm warning, so Kauai residents, you're not going to feel the effects of those winds.
Yeah, but remember that those tropical storm watches and warnings are only related to the winds. Mm-hmm. So you can still get heavy rain.
Yeah.
That's not what a tropical storm watch or warning
just
predicts.
One less thing to worry about. Check off the winds for Kauai.
Wind, no, but rain, you can still get rain.
All right. Well, thank you so much. I just want folks to know at home that it is past her bedtime. 11 o'clock was like the cutoff,
true.
But she said that, you know, she's having fun, and I hope you do have fun.
Yes.
And so, you know, if we don't get her home, she's going to turn into a pumpkin, and we can't get her back next time. But thank you very much, Dr. Alison Nugent, for breaking it down for us. You're doing a great service to the community and to the state of Hawaii with your knowledge, and I appreciate it. And I'm sure the viewing audience at home appreciates it as well. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thanks for letting me hang out so long.
Yeah, and thanks for hanging out so long. There's school tomorrow, so she's going to class, okay?
Yes.
Just letting you know. Thank you so much. You have a great rest of the evening.
Thank you.
All right. Howard.